Hey everyone, what's up? I hope you're doing fantastic. I just want to apologize for the fact that I've been absent from my channel for about a year. I kind of wanted to post like earlier in the summer, but I just got preoccupied with other things and band stuff because I'm in two bands right now. But I want to try getting some reviews out because there's tons of great stuff coming out. Wonder Years soon. By the time I post this, that might already be out because I'm recording this part September 11th, but this might not go up until October. For the sake of today's video, I will be focusing on the more punk, post-hardcore, and indie-leaning emo of mostly the first and second waves, as well as some screamo and scrams bands. There will be a handful of third, fourth, and fifth wave bands here. It's generally impossible to mention absolutely every single emo band ever in these videos. We would quite literally be here all day. Maybe one of these days I'll do a video where I focus on bands in the third, fourth, and fifth waves, aka the emo revival, which would be stuff like Paramore, Hot Mulligan, and the like. You will also notice me mention some bands who are not on the chart if you're watching. These are bands I didn't get time or didn't have a space to edit in, but still wanted to give a fair shout. With that said, let's get right into tier 1. I will be doing tier 1 and tier 2 today and posting 3 and 4 at another point down the road like this week or something. As you might know, I can drag on for pretty long about emo and pop punk. One more note to add here, if you hear me say emocore a lot, especially past the first tier, it's short for emotional hardcore, which is pretty much the first wave of emo bands, like Rites of Spring and stuff. I'll explain that as we go on. Brand New. New York band started by Jesse Lacey, who is a former member of Taking Back Sunday, another emo band who won't have a full entry here. Released, in my opinion, at least 3 of the best emo and post-hardcore albums of all time, which were Your Favorite Weapon, Deja Entendu, and The Devil and God Are Raging Inside of Me. They were influenced by a variety of bands including Fugazi, Husker Du, and Modest Mouse. They toured with bands such as Senses Fail, Good Charlotte, and Blink-182, and were among one of the most influential emo artists to come out of the really late second wave and early third wave scene, having an impact on the emo, post-hardcore, and pop-punk scenes for the next few years to come. Even still now, artists still call them an influence. Some artists they have influenced include Meme Without You, Citizen, and Oso Oso, and even one of my favorite personal bands, Thrice, came back from a hiatus in 2015 after some of their members saw a brand new concert. Sunny Day Real Estate, formed in Seattle in 1992, heavily influenced and helped establish the Midwest emo scene. They were notably signed to the label Sub Pop, notable for releasing Nirvana, Soundgarden, Mudhoney albums, among others. Released 4 albums from 1994 to 2000, most notably Diary. Nate Mendel left Sunny Day Real Estate, but continues to be a Foo Fighters member. And Sunny Day Real Estate is still touring. They're touring currently with Appleseed Cast. And their lead singer, Jeremy, is also a solo artist. I would recommend checking out their solo work as well as their 3 first albums, especially Diary. American Football, formed by Cap and Jazz member Mike Kinsella with guitarist Steve Holmes and drummer Steve Lamis. Their self-titled record released in 1999 is essential emo, notable for its artwork. The house is a popular landmark in small town Urbana, which is located just outside of Chicago. They broke up after the release due to the members not living close to each other anymore, but reunited in 2016 and have since released 2 more self-titled albums and have done multiple tours with many other Midwest emo bands. Fun fact, they have a song with Haley Williams on their 3rd release called Uncomfortably Numb. Jimmy World. Generally speaking, each of their first 5 albums from 1994's self-titled to 2004's Future are incredibly influential to not only emo and pop punk, but the alternative rock and power pop sound as a whole. During the 90s, they released splits with bands including Sense Field, Jejune, and Taking Back Sunday. They are another one of the still popular emo bands on this list, mainly because of 2001's Bleed American having extremely successful singles such as Sweetness and The Middle. Thursday is a post-hardcore band formed in 1997 in New Jersey. Their initial run went to 2013, with a reunion in 2016 before another farewell in 2019. As of 2020, they're together again. Released a few albums that were really important to the late second and third wave emo sound, alongside other well-known post-hardcore bands in the same scene, including Thrice and Under Oath. Full Collapse and War All the Time are their most successful and important albums. Vocalist Jeff Rickley also fronts or has fronted many other projects, including No Devotion with former members of Lost Prophets, and hardcore punk and grindcore band called United Nations. Jeff has also performed vocals on tracks by bands such as Touche Amore and My Chemical Romance. Orchid. One of the most important bands in screamo and power violence, or emo violence, alongside some other bands we'll talk about later, such as Page 99 and Jerome's Dream. They were heavily influenced by emo, post-hardcore, and grindcore. From 1997 until their breakup in 2002. They released three albums and two compilations alongside many splits and EPs, including splits with Pig Destroyer and Combat Wounded Veteran. The members of the band at the time of the breakup, minus Jeffrey Selane, would go on to form the band Ritual Mass, the Get Up Kids. They've toured alongside bands like Jimmy World and were another influential band on the Midwest emo scene in the second wave. 4 Minute Mile and Especially Something to Write Home About are landmark emo albums that have influenced countless musicians, including Claudio Sanchez of Coheed and Cambria and Dan Campbell of The Wonder Years. Cap'n Jazz, formed in 1989 and lasted until 1995 in its initial run. Cap'n Jazz's only album, Burrito, is one of the most influential in this wave of emo. They impacted countless bands, mainly being one of Algernon Cadwallader's main influences. Members now play in or have played in bands such as American Football, The Promise Ring, and Owls. JTree released a compilation album that you can find on streaming services, which compiles their material, plus demos, live versions, Christmas songs, etc, etc. Fun fact, the 2000s post-hardcore band Scary Kids Scaring Kids took their name from a Cap'n Jazz song of the same name. Mineral, band from Texas formed in 1994, who lasted until 1998 in its first run. Signed to Interscope Records and released two albums and multiple singles, including a split with Jimmy Eat World and Sensefield. Mineral was influenced by mainly indie bands such as Dinosaur Jr. and Sugar, which is Bob Mould's other band. Reunited in 2018 and played Furnace Fest 2021. Members have also played in other emo and indie rock acts, the most notable of them being The Gloria Record and Pop Unknown. Rites of Spring. Formed in Washington, D.C., the first of many of the essential emo core bands, along with a handful of others that will be mentioned later, released one EP and one self-titled album in 1985. Frontman Guy Picciotto and drummer Brendan Canty went on to play in Fugazi, and bassist Mike Fellows played with Silver Jews for a period. Braid. Formed in Champaign, Illinois in the early 1990s, known for their slightly dissonant leading approach to indie, emo, and math rock. Broke up in 1999, but reformed in 2011 and have remained active since. Since their formation, they have released four albums. Frontman Bob Nana also performed in Hey Mercedes. Tiny Moving Parts. Compared to most of the other bands that we've seen on this list so far, Tiny Moving Parts formed far later than any of them, starting in 2008. However, they've also had a massive impact on many of the bands who would come later, including a few of the bands that will be mentioned in a bit. Formed in Minnesota, a well-known band in the sad, tappy boy music scene, they have released 8 albums and 2 splits, including one with Old Grey. Their last two albums have been released on Hopeless Records, including their latest, which was released in August 2022. Algernon Cadwallader, known as another one of the most admired and influential emo revival acts, Algernon formed in 2005 and went to 2012 in its first run. They were known for their big twinkly, mathy guitar sound, and they went on to influence many copycats and other well-liked bands alike. They've released 2 albums and 2 EPs and have reunited and announced a North American tour for 2022. Cursive. Post-hardcore influenced band formed in 1995 in Nebraska, with influences ranging from Fugazi to Archers of Loaf. Domestica and The Ugly Organ are 2 staple albums that brought them to prominence and made them an important band in the scene in the early 2000s. Lead vocalist and guitarist Tim Kasher also has a solo career, having just released an album this year. Cursive have released 9 albums and 6 EPs. The Hotelier. Originally formed as The Hotelier in 2009 in Worcester, Massachusetts, changed their name to The Hotelier soon after. They have released 3 albums and 3 EPs, including the extremely impactful Home Like No Place Is There, and continue to play shows. Touche Amore. Formed in 2007 in Los Angeles, they are known as one of the more popular bands at the forefront of the mid-2000s screamo post-hardcore style, along with bands like Pianos Become the Teeth and La Dispute. They have released 5 studio albums, a live album, a re-recording of their first album for its 10th anniversary, and numerous splits and EPs, including one with La Dispute and one with the Casket Lottery. La Dispute. La Dispute formed in 2004 in Grand Rapids, Michigan, and have released 4 studio albums, a soundtrack album, many EPs and splits, and a remix album, which is of their latest album, Panorama. Alongside Touche Amore and many other bands in the same scenes, appeared on a Nirvana cover compilation called Whatever Nevermind, performing a cover of Polly. The Promise Ring. Another band with a Cap and Jazz member and vocalist and guitarist Davey Von Bullen. Formed in Milwaukee in 1995 and have since released 4 full-length albums and 6 EPs, including a split with Texas Is the Reason. The band broke up in 2002 after releasing Wood Water, but reunited on many occasions, however, never released another album. Besides Davey, another notable member of the band is bassist Scott Schoenbeck, who currently plays bass for Dashboard Confessional. Envy, Japanese screamo band formed in 1992, while primarily starting off as a post-hardcore and screamo band, they later began to take on elements of post-rock. They have released 7 studio albums and numerous splits and EPs, notably with post-hardcore band Thursday, who were mentioned earlier. Cloud Nothings. Another stranger one on this list to me, since most of their stuff isn't really mainly emo, but I'll cover this band still. Formed in 2009 as a solo project of Dylan Baldy, he takes influence from multiple genres including post-hardcore, post-punk, and noise rock. Has released 9 albums, a live album, and countless EPs, mainly released during 2020 and 2021. They have also released a collab album with Waves, an alternative rock band. The Brave Little Abacus. One of the more underappreciated emo revival bands, they formed in 2007 in New Hampshire, and while their releases weren't very popular early on, they have gained a large cult following due to the Slash Mew board on 4chan, as well as Rate Your Music, mainly from their last full length, Just Got Back from the Discomfort, We're Alright. The band broke up in 2012. The World Is a Beautiful Place and I'm No Longer Afraid to Die started in 2009 and still active to this day, having released a full length in 2021 called Illusory Walls. Their style ranges from influence in emo and post-hardcore to post-rock and space rock. They have underwent many lineup changes, but bassist and sometimes vocalist Jason Sear is the only original member. They have released 4 albums and many EPs and splits, including some with Tiger's Jaw, Code Orange, Sorority Noise, and Self-Defense Family. Marietta, Midwest emo band formed in 2011, have released 2 full-length studio albums and many splits and EPs. Most notably a split with Modern Baseball called Couples Therapy. They broke up in 2015. Merchant Ships. Screamo band formed in 2008, consists of members from both South Bend, Indiana and Sturgis, Michigan. They had 2 releases and broke up for the first time in 2009. Keep this in mind for the next entry. Reunited to release 1 more EP and some singles, but broke up permanently after a small tour due to creative differences. Midwest Pen Pals. I'm kind of surprised they were put this high, but as you can guess, these tiers are arbitrary, so you might see more oddities later, either too high or too low. They were formed after Merchant Ships broke up for the first time in 2009, Midwest Pen Pals lasted from June to September 2009 and released one release, Inside Jokes. They were supposed to release a full length and a split with Ape Up and Boys and Sex, but this never happened. Members went on to form William Bonney and Park Jefferson. Seisha. Formed in 1997 and lasting until 1999 in their initial run, they released one album and three EPs during this time, and a posthumous release in 2016. Also have two compilation albums, which both include the band's full recorded discography. This was a popular release format for many emo, screamo, and hardcore bands in the 80s and 90s. After their breakup, members would play in other bands including Hot Cross and Interpol. Reunited earlier this year with a post on Instagram saying they jammed for the first time in 24 years. The Appleseed Cast. Formed in 1997 in Kansas, they combined alternative and emo with post-rock elements. The band has never broken up or went on hiatus, but has had many lineup changes. Christopher Krischi has remained the band's main songwriter for their entire run. They have released 8 studio albums and 4 EPs, including a split with Planes Mistaken for Stars, and they have toured with bands such as Caspian and are currently going on tour with Sunny Day Release Date, as mentioned earlier. Old Grey. Mentioned earlier in the Tiny Moving Parts entry, they are an emo and screamo band out of New Hampshire. They are one of many Cameron Boucher projects. Cameron would also form Sorority Noise later on. Old Grey was active from 2011 to 2018 and released 2 full-length albums and 4 EPs. Tiger's Jaw. Started within the same pop-punk scene that gave us Menzingers, Captain We're Sinking, and The Wonder Years. Tiger's Jaw formed in 2005 between Ben Walsh and Adam McElwee as a more lo-fi sounding indie project, with keyboardist and vocalist Brianna Collins joining a bit later. They have played shows with bands including Touche Amore and Tidal Flight, and have released 6 studio albums, a live album, many EPs and splits, including with Balance and Composure and Kevin Devine. Empire, I Was a Lonely Estate. Started as a solo project of Keith Lettinen in 2006 in Fenton, Michigan. He would soon recruit his wife, Kathy, as a secondary guitarist and vocalist, with a revolving cast of drummers and bassists for both recording and live performances. They were very influenced and often compared to bands from the second wave emo scene, including American Football. Released 2 albums, 5 EPs, and many splits, including with Football, Etc., Joie de Vivre, Into It, Over It, and Modern Baseball. Broke up in 2016 after playing a final show in Flint, Michigan, with support from Cardboard Swords, Joie de Vivre, and more. This Town Needs Guns, later shortened to TTNG. Formed in 2004 in Oxford, England, brothers Chris and Tim Collis have been the only original members of this math rock band since its inception. Have released 4 albums and 3 EPs and have never broken up. Drive Like Jehu. Post-hardcore band formed in 1990 in California, mainly influenced by no-wave and alternative punk acts, including Sonic Youth, Honor Roll, and Wipers. Heavily impacted the transition from emo-core of the 80s to emo bands in the 90s, who would experiment with varying genres such as indie rock and post-hardcore. Members including John Reese, who would also perform in Rocket from the Crypt, and Mark Trombino, a producer and engineer who has worked on songs for many punk bands, including Blink-182, Motion City Soundtrack, and fellow emo band Jimmy Eat World. Multiple members, including John Reese, also play in Hot Snakes. Drive Like Jehu released 2 albums and a single during their short career, but reunited in 2014 for a few years. They would go on to influence not only emo and post-hardcore bands, but many artists in the alternative and noise rock scenes, including Violent Soho, Metz, and even grindcore act Genghis Tron. Hot Water Music. Formed in 1994 in Gainesville, Florida by Chuck Reagan and Chuck Woolard, who also fronts The Draft and Ship Thieves, they employ elements of emo, especially in their earlier career, post-hardcore and melodic hardcore in their music. And their 2002 album, Caution, is a popular and good example of their sound. They have released 9 albums, 2 live albums, and many EPs and splits, including one with fellow punk rock band Alkaline Trio. Let's move on to Tier 2. Tier 2. This is where we get a little bit more obscure, but most of these bands, I feel like, as long as you know at least half of them, you're pretty experienced. City of Caterpillar. post-hardcore and post-rock band from Virginia, formed initially in 2000 and going to 2003, released one album in 2002, as well as many EPs and demos. Would reform in 2016 to play some festivals, and the band is going strong to this day, releasing an album later in 2022. The band has had members who played in Page 99, Stop It, and Majority Rule. Crash of Rhinos, formed in Derby, England in 2009 and lasting until 2014, they put out two albums, including Knots in 2013 on Top Shelf Records. They took influence from many 90s emo acts, including Jawbreaker. Lifetime, though mainly considered a major player in the melodic hardcore scene of the 90s, it should not be denied that their second studio album, Hello Bastards, released in 1995 on JJJ Records, is a huge influence on the emo core scene as well. The album also features a popular cover of Husker Du's It's Not Funny Anymore. Lifetime have released four albums, including a self-titled release in 2007 on labels Fueled by Ramen and Decadence, the label started by Fall Out Boy members Patrick Stump and Pete Wentz. Lifetime formed in New Jersey in 1990 and lasted until 1997 in its initial run, but reformed in 2005 and is still playing shows to this present day, including a spot at South by Southwest and some shows supporting fellow melodic hardcore act Bouncing Souls. Dag Nasty, melodic hardcore leaning emo band formed in 1985 in Washington, D.C., amidst the emotional hardcore scene. Their style impacted the sound of post-hardcore, notable for having members who had played or would go on to play in Minor Threats, Descendants, Fugazi, and Samhain. Broke up many times but have gone on to reunite sporadically, most recently in 2015, still playing some shows as of recent, including Punk Rock Bowling Fest in 2016. Dogleg, post-hardcore band formed in 2015, have played shows at South by Southwest representing Michigan, and released their debut album Melee on Triple Crown Records. They announced that they were supporting Touche Amore and Vain FM on their 2022 North American tour, but due to allegations brought towards frontman Alex Stoitsidius, which include toxic behavior and relationships, the band went on indefinite hiatus in 2021. Snowing, formed in 2008 in Philadelphia, they are another immensely popular emo band formed in the emo revival scene, released one album and some EPs before parting ways in 2011. Reunited a handful of times for some one-off shows or tours, including a show with The World is a Beautiful Place and I'm No Longer Afraid to Die, and most recently reunited in 2022. Embrace, hardcore punk band from Washington, D.C. that lasted between 1985 and 1986. Along with Rites of Spring and Beefeater, they were one of the popular acts during the Revolution Summer, a social movement that was in favor of straight edge and veganism and animal rights, and in opposition of the violence and moshing that had come out of the hardcore scene out of that time. This term will come up a lot in the next few tiers, so just keep it in mind. Embrace was most well known for having Ian McKay of the recently broken up Minor Threat. They only ever released one self-titled posthumous release in 1987, and Ian McKay would go on to form Fugazi, and guitarist Michael Hampton would form One Last Wish with three members of Rites of Spring. One Last Wish, as mentioned just previously, was a short-lived post-hardcore band formed of Michael Hampton of Embrace, as well as three members of emo pioneer band Rites of Spring, Brennan Canty, Edward Janney, and Guy Picciotto. They were active from 86 to 87 and broke up before an album could be released. However, their final finished product was finally released in 1999, 13 years after the breakup. Members would form and or join other bands such as Happy Go Licky, who were technically a reincarnation of One Last Wish, but much more experimental, Manifesto, and yes, Fugazi. Moss Icon, hardcore punk band formed in 1986 and lasting until 1991, they were also influential to post-hardcore and emo, even though they, like many other bands of this time including Rites of Spring, denied this. Released a demo, many 7-inches, and 3 LPs including a split LP with Silver Bearing. After the 1991 breakup, they reunited a handful of times including in 2007, and are still playing occasional shows as of 2014. Funeral Diner. Similar to City of Caterpillar, Screamo band with post-rock tendencies, formed in 1998 in Half Moon Bay, California. Released two albums and many EPs and compilation appearances. Members have played in or would go on to play in bands such as Portraits of Past and Lemonade. Willie and Bonnie. No, not the outlaw guy. Willie and Bonnie were a Midwest screamo band that ran from 2010 to 2013. Released two EPs and a split EP with Droughts, and a few compilations including All 10, which compiles everything they've released. The band consisted of members of Midwest Pen Pals and Merchant Ships. Everyone Asked About You. Indie and Midwest emo band that formed in 1997 in Arkansas, lasting until 1999. Released two EPs and a split with the Shyness Clinic. They didn't have much of a following during the run, but earned a cult following much later on. They had an album finished, but it wasn't released until 2012. Texas Is the Reason. Post-hardcore band formed in 1994 in New York by Norman Brannan of hardcore band Shelter. Released one studio album, a live split album with Samiam, and three EPs, which include splits with The Promise Ring and Samuel. After their breakup in 1997, member Chris Daly would go on to join Jets to Brazil, while members Norman Brannan and Scott Weingard would go on to play in The New and Original with members of Far and Chamberlain. They have reunited a handful of times, most recently in 2016. Heroin. Hardcore punk band formed in California who pioneered the screamo genre during their four-year run from 89 to 93. Released a total of 18 songs among a handful of EPs. Members would go on to play with bands such as Moander, Antioch Arrow, and Battalion of Saints, and many artists have noted them as an influence, including Jeff Rickley of Thursday. Rain, Italian screamo band formed in 2002 and running until 2005 in its initial formation. Heavily influential and responsible for bringing the screamo scene to Europe. Beefeater, emotional hardcore band who, like Rites of Spring and Embrace, were part of the 1985 Revolution Summer Movement. Between 84 and 87, had three releases before splitting. Not a ton is known about what members did after splitting, other than Fred Smith joining gothic punk band Strange Boutique. Fred Smith passed away in 2017. Page 99. Screamo band formed in 1997, who would incorporate elements of power violence and grindcore in their sound. Known as pioneers of screamo and emo violence, along with Jerome's Dream. Disbanded in 2003 as an 8-piece, before rebanding in 2011 and later in 2017. Released many EPs and LPs, including splits with Majority Rule and City of Caterpillar. Chrissy Front Drive. Emo core band formed in 1993, influenced by Superchunk and Jawbreaker, among others. They released one album and two EPs, including a split EP with Boys Life, and broke up in 1997. They also released a split with Jimmy Eat World in 1995. They have reunited for some one-off performances in 2007 and 2014, though only having a short lifetime as a band. They were a major influence to the scene, and members would go on to form many other bands, including Antarctica, and post-rock and emo band The Blue Ontario. Eric Richer also sang backing vocals on Jimmy Eat World's second album, Stag Prevails. I Hate Myself. Post-hardcore and indie band formed in 1996 in Gainesville, Florida. Home to many other great punk acts, including Hot Water Music, who were mentioned earlier. They released one album, 10 songs, and an EP entitled 4 Songs in 1997, before splitting the same year. They posthumously released a few more EPs, including a split with Strikeforce Diablo, and they reunited for two shows in 2003, and recorded some new material in 2005. Members now play in hardcore and mathcore band Die Hoffnung. I Wrote Haikus About Cannibalism in Your Yearbook. Formed in Antioch, California, and active from 2004 to 2007, I Wrote Haikus were one of the more popular screamo bands, as is made evident by how high they are. There's not a whole lot to say about them that other sources like Sophie's Floorboards haven't said already, but they've released two albums and a demo EP. Members went on to play in Bon Navier and other related bands. Jerome's Dream. Screamo pioneers formed in 1997 in Connecticut, and fronted by lead vocalist and bassist Jeff Smith. The band started off with traditional high screen vocals, but after Jeff lost his voice during a recording session, later releases would have more of a hardcore punk approach. Think Minor Threat, just slightly different. They have record splits with fellow emo bands, Usurp Synapse, and most famously, Orchid. They were one of the most influential in their scene due to how different from other bands they sounded at the time, with unique live shows where Jeff would not sing into a microphone, rather screamed at the top of his lungs with his back turned to the audience. They broke up in 2001, but reformed again in 2018 and are playing shows to this day. They record 4 albums and many splits. The majority of this material, everything recorded between 1997 to 2001, being compiled in a 2005 compilation album called Completed, is easily found on streaming services and Bandcamp. Circle takes the square. Grindcore-influenced screamo band formed in Savannah, Georgia in 1999, fronted by bassist and vocalist Kathleen Stoblek. Unlike many other bands on this list, they have never broken up. They are one of the pioneers of their brand of emotional, experimental, post-hardcore, a list which also includes Page 99 and Orchid, according to NPR music writer Lars Gottrick. They have released 2 studio albums and 3 EPs, including a split with Page 99. Penfold. Formed in 1995 in New Jersey and lasting until March 2003, they were a Midwest emo act. They had 3 releases, including 2 albums. Information on the band otherwise is slightly sparse. The members went on to play in the Moray before Penfold reunited for a one-off show in Bound Brook, New Jersey. Vitreous Humor. Formed in the same scene in Kansas as Appleseed Cast, The Anniversary, and Boys Life in 1990, they released 1 posthumous album, which was later reissued a few years later, and a handful of splits, including with fellow Kansas band Boys Life. They toured with bands like Everclear, and even had one of their songs covered by Not a Surf, but the tensions of touring led them to breaking up in 1996. Loma Prieta, heavily hardcore-influenced screamo act formed in 2005 in California. They frequently toured around North America and Europe, supporting bands such as Birds in a Row and Converge. They have released 5 albums and 3 EPs, including a split with the previously mentioned Rain. Off Minor, screamo band formed in 1999 out of New York by a few former Satcha members. The band combined influences of emo, math rock, and jazz rock into their sound. They released 3 studio albums and many EPs and splits, including one with Ampere. Portrayal of Guilt. Formed in 2017 in Texas, they have a unique sound combining a form of dissonant sounding blackened screamo and power violence. They have been compared to bands like Converge, with their music filled with a sense of despair. They have released 3 full-length studio albums and 6 EPs, including splits with Chatpile and Softkill. They have collaborated on artwork on tracks with artists such as Chris Taylor from Page 99 and Jeremy Bolm from Touche Amore, the latter doing vocals on the track Fall from Grace from Portrayal of Guilt's last album Christfucker. The Van Pelt, indie rock band out of New York City, formed in 1993. The band was fronted by one Chris Leo, formerly of Knave Nod and the brother of Ted Leo, who would go on to be frontman of Ted Leo and the Pharmacists, as well as The Both. Released 3 studio albums, a live album, and several splits and EPs. Bassist Toko Yasuda would go on to have a brief stint in Blonde Redhead, Enon, and would be a live bassist for St. Vincent. She also played keyboards on a Sleater-Kinney tour. Guitarist Brian Mariansky would go on to appear in the Jawbreaker offshoot Jets to Brazil, as well as doing artwork for several artists, including Texas Is the Reason. They would reunite briefly in 2009 and again in 2014 to play some shows and festivals. I would heavily recommend their second album, Sultans of Sentiment. Boys Life, Midwest emo band formed in Kansas in 1993. Heavily influenced some early third wave bands, including Taking Back Sunday. The band would break up in 1997 and form other projects, including slowcore act Canyon, released 2 albums and many split EPs, including one with Chrissy Front Drive. They reunited briefly for a tour in 2015, as well as a reissue of their second album. Foxing. I don't know why these guys are solo, because they're pretty popular and even have their own Audio Tree Live, but Tears are arbitrary, so I won't bump on it too much. They are a Midwest emo outfit formed in Missouri in 2011. They've released 4 studio albums, including one in 2021, an EP, a live album, and 2 splits with Japanese Breakfast and Send Away a Stranger. Over their 11-year career, the band has toured with other emo and punk acts, including TTNG and Balance and Composure. Everyone Everywhere. Midwest emo band formed in 2007 in Philadelphia. They have released 2 studio albums, 2 EPs, and a split EP with Into It, Over It. Their sound is for fans of bands like Dads and Modern Baseball, and their most recent album from 2012 is my recommendation for anybody looking to get into this band. Members have also performed in the indie rock and power pop act Hurry, also from Philadelphia. Lord Snow, screamo band formed in 2011, known for their chaotic, math rock inspired approach to their sound and their unique vocals from front person Steph Maldonado, have released 2 studio albums and many splits and EPs, and even appeared on an Orchid tribute compilation along with Full of Hell, For Want Of, and You'll Live. Members also play in similar bands such as Suffix and Raw Nerve. Gospel. Progressive rock influenced screamo and post-hardcore band formed in Brooklyn in 2003. Often cited prog punk in the same fashion that bands such as Propagandhi and even Plains Mistaken for Stars are, gospel also adds psychedelic and ambient structures to their sound, making for a sound that was truly unique at the time. They have been influenced by many acts such as Metallica, Genesis, and Mahavishnu Orchestra. They have broken up a few times, but as of 2018, they are still playing shows. They have released 2 albums, the most recent being in 2022, and an EP. Gospel also has 2 live albums and a split release with Coden Armada. Indian Summer, along with Cap'n Jazz, Rites of Spring, and Moss Icon, one of the cornerstones of second wave emo. Indian Summer was formed in 1993 in Oakland, California. They were an underground band who helped define the sound of late 90s screamo from acts such as Orchid. 2019's Giving Birth to Thunder is a collection of their older work, most being their Science 1994 LP. Indian Summer is a rare example of one of the more hardcore influenced acts who actually embraced the emo term, even going as far as tweeting "Give emo a chance" with a playlist of music from artists that ends in the mid-90s. Indian Summer broke up in 1994, 1 year after their inception, but their legacy has influenced many bands to come. Vocalist-guitarist Mark Bianchi would later go on to play in Mohinder, and currently has an Indie-tronica act called Her Space Holiday. Portraits of Past. Active from 1994 to 1995, the band helped define the sound of screamo, though they were known as just a post-hardcore band when they were active. They remained mainly an underground act until well after their breakup, released 1 studio album and 2 EPs during their time together, all of which would be compiled into a compilation. Reunited to play a handful of shows where they would showcase new material in 2008 and 2009, and release an EP of new material in 2009 before another breakup. I Would Set Myself on Fire for You, a post-rock influenced screamo act in the same vein and scene as Jerome's Dream, Circle Takes the Square, and others. Formed in 2001 in Atlanta, Georgia, and broke up in 2007. They had a unique approach to their subgenre, including 3 vocalists, and would compose songs on instruments including viola and cello. Released 2 songs posthumously on their Bandcamp in 2012. Link. Formed in Olympia, Washington in 1992 and lasting until 1994, they were a post-hardcore band that took influence from acts such as Drive Like Jehu. Later influenced many acts such as The Promise Ring. They released 1 album and a compilation of material that would not end up on said album. Before they released their only album, members James Bertram and Sam Jane would play on Beck's album, One Foot in the Grave. And after the breakup, Dave Schneider and Bertram would later join bands such as Built to Spill as touring members. The newfound interest in Connecticut, post-rock leaning emo band from Toronto, Canada, that lasted 3 years. Not a whole lot of information is available on this band, which makes me wonder why they were put in this tier, but they released 1 album and 1 EP. Drummer Mosh Rosenberg worked with fellow Toronto band Fucked Up during the production of an album, as well as working on drums on an Always album, Antisocialites. Love Lost But Not Forgotten, screamo and emo violence act from Misery, formed in 1997. Broke up in 2003, but have reunited a handful of times for reunion shows, the most recent being in 2010. They released 2 studio albums and some EPs and splits, including one with Joshua Fit for Battle.